Good afternoon, everybody. Hello, I'm Olaf Jansen. It's a pity I can't join you today at your kickoff session because actually today I'm in Germany where my brother-in-law is getting married. So to replace my physical presence with you, I decided to record a video that you're now watching. And what I'm trying to tell you in the next 30 minutes or so, or to explain you actually, is how you can access materials that are related to the KB ALBA. And I made a presentation for this, so you can actually look at what I have to tell. And now let me see if I can manage to load that presentation. This one, so if everything goes well, this should be the opening slide about how you can access KB ALBA, ALBA Amicorum on Wikimedia. And just to make clear what my aims for this next half hour are, actually those are three aims. The first one is to explain you how and where you can obtain working materials for your assignment if you want to work with digitized images and data for the ALBA of the KB. I also hope to be able to inspire you about all the possibilities that you can do with KB ALBA and the images and the data related to those ALBA. And thirdly, I'm not trying to limit you in your inspiration and creativity to the examples of the ALBA that I will be showing you in my presentation. If you want to work with other ALBA that I don't show in my presentation, that's also very fine. You're free to to let your creativity and imagination go. On the other hand, if you feel comfortable with working with the examples that I will show you, of course, that's also very fine. And I would like to start my story with looking at a particular case study that was also mentioned in your course assignment description, related to the album Amicorum of Jacob Heijblok. And a typical album Amicorum, as Jeroen probably already explained to you earlier today, consists of contributions. And this one about Heijblok, this is a particular interesting one because from this 17th century album, a lot of famous Dutch artists from that era, they contributed to the album, like the famous poet Joost van der Vondel, or the drawer, draftsman Jan de Brij. And I think most famous of all is a contribution by Rembrandt van Rijn. And just look at the structure of a typical contribution. Well, of course, there is some text here, some contribution itself, but there is at the bottom here, for most contributions, there's also a location, so where the contribution was made, this in particular case, Amsterdam. And the date was the 3rd of August, 1645. And I will show you that this kind of information later on in my slides will be very useful to make data visualizations from. Now I would like to look at how we as KB present that particular album, the AAJH you see here, that's about the album Amicorum Jacob Heijblok, how we present that information on our own website, so on kb.nl. And we do that actually in a fourfold manner. First of all, we have a high resolution image viewer where the image where you can look at the album in high resolution, you can leaf through the album as if it was in front of you in high resolution images. Secondly, then we have typically a Dutch language page where contextual information, so background information about this particular album is written up. For this album, there is a list of friends, vrienden in Dutch, and these are actually the contributors to the album. And this is also available from that, that page here at the bottom of the page if you scroll down. And here you see an inventory of all the people that contributed to this album. And the ones that are encircled in red, those are actually the ones that are also mentioned in your course assignment that I looked at before preparing for this this presentation. And finally, there is a description of the particular album in the catalog of the KB. By the way, I should point out that at the bottom of my slides, I typically put the URLs to the pages you see in the slide. So this, for instance, these two URLs are, if you would click on those, then you would see this particular page. And this is for, I did it for as many slides as possible. Going back to that image viewer, there is really one major disadvantage of that image viewer, and that is the fact that you can't download this image from that image viewer. This is not possible. And the same goes for other ALBA that are presented on KB, on the KB website via this image viewer system. For instance, this one, the album by Jacoba Bolte, also such an image viewer, but you can't download the images you see here on the screen. And the same goes for the album of Petronella Moons, or for this one, the album of Samuel Johannes van den Berg. Also, the images are not downloadable. But yeah, then you might wonder, well, I really want to work with those digital images for my project, for my assignment. How do I get the images if I can't download them from the KB website? Well, this is where Wikimedia comes into play. Because for an increasing amount of albums, we put on new ALBA regularly, but in this case, you see there are 84 ALBA from the collection of the KB. And for some of those ALBA, we upload the digitized images to a website that is called Wikimedia Commons. And Wikimedia Commons is a big image database, you could say, image storage, where millions and millions of images are available. And the common denominator of all those images is that you can actually reuse them freely. So there is no copyright, etc. And no, don't have to pay any money to use these images. And that's why we put on our images of our historical ALBA. So there is no copyright on those images, which would hinder you to work with those images. And Wikimedia Commons, I think, is best known because Wikipedia stores its images on Wikimedia Commons. So all the images you see in Wikipedia are stored in Wikimedia Commons. And as the KB, we also store our ALBA images on the same website. And now you see, if you look closely here, you see that here in this is called a category, like a little container where you can put in images. You see from the Heiblok album, there are 248 of those images of that album available. From the Jacoba Bolton album, there are 74 files available. Here in this corner, Petronella Moons is available with just under 200 images. And here at the bottom, also from the Van den Berg album with 55 images. And here do you see, if you look at the other numbers for this particular album, there are just under 700 images available for this one from Ernst Brink, which I will come back to later, nearly 180 images. And this one, the Hiskia van Haringsma album, 33 files. And if you then click on any of these categories, for instance, this one, again, the Heiblok one, you come on this page. And then when you scroll down a bit, you see a list of all the images that are available. And in the red corner there, in the red box here, you see that image of that mackerel, that fish. And then when you click on here, you go to this file page where this image is shown and some other things related to the image are shown. But the most important, I think, for you is here, is that you can actually download that image in a number of various resolutions, where this one, the 1500x915 pixel one, is the currently the best resolution available. And the same logic goes for all the other images, not only for our ALBA, but all the other images you see on Wikimedia Commons can be downloaded in such a way. I would like to point out that for selected ALBA, we don't have only those individual images like you see here from the mackerel, but also we have stored double page openings, so double images. So these are actually like two individual image files or pages, I could say, folio to be correct, joined together. And you can actually download also those in the same manner. And you see you have these kinds of double page openings. And I could imagine some use cases where these combined images are actually more useful than the individual ones, because this gives a more truthful representation of the album itself. Okay, I just talked about how you can download individual images. So if you want to download those, you have to do that image by image by image. But you can imagine if you want to have, like, say, all those 700 images of that one album I showed you, that's a lot of work. You have to download 700 files one by one by one. So you might wonder, are there any tools available with which I can download all the images of a particular album in one go, in one batch? And the answer to that question is yes, there are actually two tools available that enable you to download images in a batch format, so in one go. And the first tool is called Imgur, and the second tool is called Wiki Loves Downloads. And let me show you both tools now, actually. And the first one, the Imgur tool, that is available on this URL. And if you click on that URL, you see this particular page. And then when you look here, you look at Quick Start. And there in the red box, this is, by the way, I should point out, this is a little application, a little bit of software you need to install on your laptop. So you go here and you go to this page on GitHub, and from there you can download that particular zip file here. And if you unzip that, you can run this this executable, this Windows executable. And if you run that, you get this bit of this user interface, this bit of software. And how do you use that? Well, let's assume that we want to download all the images, all the 55 images in this case, of this particular album in their highest resolutions in bulk. Well, what you do, then you copy paste the name of this category, so album icorum la la la. You copy paste that into the Imgur tool. You then specify the location where you want those images to be downloaded to. Then you click on here. If you get that, it starts to build a file list, and once that is done, it will take a couple of seconds. Then you click on that button, and it starts downloading all those images. That might take a while if there are many images to be downloaded. And then when you look at the location that you specified, in this case the downloads folder on my own Windows laptop, you see that there are actually all those 55 images have actually been downloaded. And then you can start using them. And you see there is this, well, pretty decent resolution. Okay, the second tool I would like to talk about is the Wikiloves download tool, available from this URL. But if you click on this URL, it will give you a German language interface, which might be a bit tricky to understand. So if you put that interface into Google Translate, you can actually read it in English. And I should point out, using this tool will not download the images themselves, as the Imgur tool did, but it will only download the URLs of the images, so the pointers to the images. For instance, if you want to say, well, we want to have the same album, the same Van den Berg album, and you want to say, well, I want to have one list of URLs. You can also have two, then you get two separate lists of URLs, but it's easy to get one. You fill that out, you click on the generate download list button here. Then it starts to generate this zip file. And if you then unpack that, and you unpack the text file that is in that zip file, you see here that you actually have downloaded the URL of the image. And when you would copy paste that into your browser, or if you would copy this list into a download manager or something, you can actually get the high resolution the high resolution image that you needed. Okay, this is pretty much what I wanted to show you about the images. If you now want to work with images for particular ALBA that are not yet completely on Commons, but you really like to get hold of those images, you can ask me, because I have some other tools and stuff and scripts available with which I can obtain all ALBA images of the entire KB. But I didn't yet have time to upload all those images to Wikimedia Commons. If you need them for your project, just send me an email and I can see, well, probably I can get you the images. For instance, if you want to work with the ALBA that Jeroen selected for the project, if all went well and our preparation went well, Jeroen sent you, or gave you this earlier today, this list of 15 ALBA that he selected for you to use if you want to use them. If you don't want to use the ALBA in this list, this is also fine, but if you will use them, if you can use them, then we're also happy. So Jeroen gave you this list. And what I did is I converted this Word document actually to a table with structured data. And this table is available on this URL here. I made this page particularly for you for this course. And using this table, I will show you what kind of data is available for the ALBA themselves. Because if I do this in this Word file, it's not going to work really nicely. It's better to work from this table, because you can, for instance, also sort the table, as you see here with the little arrows. And just let me get this one, this album Amicorum of Ernst Brink, his first album, because he actually made two or three ALBA, I think. But this is the first of his ALBA. You see that there is a start date listed, 1602, and a date at which the album was stopped being created, 1649 in this case. Next, there is this inventory number, also called signature or shelf mark. This is a number within the KB by which this album is known. Then here, there is this resolver URL. This is actually a link to the catalog record, so the metadata about this album in our KB catalog. Then there is a link to the images on Wikimedia Commons that I talked in the previous section of my presentation about. And at the right-hand column, there is this link to the contextual information on kb.nl, where you can read a bit more background information about this particular album. And then finally, the very first column, if you click on this link, then you will actually go to a page where even more metadata about this particular album is available. This site is called Wikidata, as you can see here. And Wikidata is a sister site of Wikimedia Commons and of Wikipedia. And in Wikimedia Commons, as we saw, we store images. On Wikipedia, you store articles, so you store contextual information. And on Wikidata, you store, metadata, structured data, facts, dry facts about, in this case, this particular album. And the combination between Wikidata, Wikimedia Commons, and Wikipedia, that's a combination that not only the KB, but a lot of cultural heritage organizations use. But I will not go into the nitty-gritty of Wikidata. I just want to show you what it is, and that you can find all kinds of additional information about this particular album in Wikidata. The list that I showed you, that I created from the Word document that Jeroen made, contains 15 alba. But if you want to work with more alba, you're lucky, because the KB has in total more than 650 other alba, which are described via a Wikidata page on Wikidata. So this is this page. If you go to this URL, you get a really long list of more than 650 different alba. If you would like to work with those alba, or with, let's say, selections or groups of particular alba, and you need more data than is currently listed on Wikidata, again, please come to me, because then I can check and tell you what is actually would be possible, or if you have certain requests, if they are actually feasible. Let's assume you want to say, well, I want to have all data about all 650 images completely. Then I say, well, within the time frame that we have for the course and within the resources that we have in the KB, that's not a feasible request. But if you have a bit more modest request, then I can see what I can do for you to help you. Okay, going back to this Wikidata page about the Ernst Brink album. If you scroll down here on the page, then you come across a list of all the individual contributions that were made in this album. And this list of contributions, it's a bit of, it's not really, you can't tell a lot about this list. You see the titles or the names of these contributions. So what I did, I converted this list into another list, with actually a bit more, which is a bit more attractive to look at. Hey, you see, for instance, the images that are related to these particular album contributions, etc. And this one is for the Ernst Brink album, but there is also such a table available for the Haringsma to Sloten album, or even of course for the Heiblok album. And just let me look at this table to show you what you can actually kind of things you can do with the data that is provided in this table. So here, for instance, you have an image about the contribution and the title of the contribution that was made by, in this case, Franciscus Snellings. Then every contribution has its own inventory number and catalog record. So not only this is valid for what I already showed you, the full alba, the alba themselves, but also the album contributions have their own inventory number and catalog records. This is not really particularly interesting. It gets more interesting now, because you see, this is actually what I told you at the very beginning of my story, that quite a decent amount, of contributions have dates with them, like the ones you see here. So you can imagine, if you get all those various dates, you can start to make a timeline visualization. So when in time these contributions were done. The last two columns of this overview contain the place of creation. So this is just a text label, like in Leiden or Amsterdam, you see. But also the longitude and latitude coordinates of Leiden or Amsterdam. And if you have this, you can start to create a map. So a place or a map of the places where all these various contributions were actually made. And you get something like this. Okay, I've arrived at the last part of my story. In the previous parts, I looked at the full alba, the alba themselves. I looked at the images of the alba, I looked at the individual contributions of the ALBA. But there's one more thing we need to talk about, and this is the people that actually made those contributions. So I'm talking about the album contributors. So in the final bit of my story, I would like to look at those contributors, those people. And I would like, again, to start with the contributors of the Heiblok album. And I already showed you in the beginning of my story that there is this inventory of people that contributed to the album on the KB website. What I did, I converted this list again in a similar table, which is handier to work with, because now I can show you what you can actually do with the information that is provided in this table. For instance, if you first look at these two columns, you have these names of the contributors, like famous painter Rembrandt, but also famous poet Katz, etc. All quite famous people from the Dutch Golden Age, the 17th century. And you have, for quite a number of contributors, you have like images, how they look like. And if you combine that, you can start to create a data visualization like a Facebook. So an image gallery of those people together. And you see here that the contributors are actually depicted. But you also notice that there are also quite a number of images that have this question mark. And this is to represent people that were known to have contributed to the album, but don't have their own images. And you see here, there is a female image. So this was actually Cornelia van der Veer, if you look closely. So it was a female contributor to the album. And the rest were all, as you can see, males that, in this case, don't have their own portraits. Another way to look at it is like this graph view representation. So in the middle, you have the album. And then around the center, all these individual contributors are like a big wheel or something, or a cartwheel that are around it. And this image that that I generated really reminded me of this image, which is comes from your assignment instructions, about being creating like a network of people. Which brings me to another page from your assignment paper, this one. And I was particularly struck by one phrase from that page, talking about that this Jacob Heiblok album can really be seen as a precursor of social media. So the album Heiblok was actually some kind of old school social media thing. And this reminded me of an experiment that we did in the KB recently, is to see if we could like mix up old school new media, the album, with new school social media, like something like Facebook or something, or Instagram. So we did a session, we did a couple of sessions with that, and we came up with some basic prototypes of how that mix up between old school and new school social media could look like. And we created, for instance, a user page, a profile, a social media profile, I need to say, about Rembrandt van Rijn. And then if you scroll down, you actually see, for instance, that in his friends, this section about his friends, the contributors to the Heiblok album are actually listed. And in his timeline, here says in Dutch, I'm just sketching, doing some sketching away. And then if you look closely, this is the sketch he made for the Heiblok album. So this was a way for us to explore the combination between, old school social media in that album and new school internet social media. Okay. I go back to that table that I was working with to show you a bit more. If you click on here, I'm going to talk about Rembrandt, as you can see. This is a link to the Wikimedia Commons category of Rembrandt. So in this category, you can find all kinds of other images that are related to Rembrandt, not only about portraits of Rembrandt, of other works by Rembrandt, but also monuments and memorials to Rembrandt, catalogs of art, books about Rembrandt, something about Rembrandt's family, the Rembrandt House Museum, etc. So all kinds of media and also some videos you see, media and images related to Rembrandt are available from this category on Wikimedia Commons. So this might, if you would browse through these, you might be inspired to get some ideas to work with. There's actually another way to get to this very same category, and this is by going to the category contributors to the album Amicorum Jacob Heijblok. And what I did, I made all separate subcategories about all these individual contributors to that album, which hold other images related to those contributors. And in this case, what we saw, Rembrandt. So this is just another entry to find related images and media files for particular contributors to the Heijblok album. Okay, going back to the table once more. You can also go to a Wikipedia article about Rembrandt van Rijn. And in this case, it's a Dutch one. So reading the Wikipedia article, you might get additional ideas that you could perhaps use in your assignment or in your project. And if you say, well, I don't want to read the Dutch Wikipedia article, go to the left bottom corner of this page, and then you will find a menu where you can choose from how many? nearly 160 other languages this Wikipedia article is available in. All for you to create working materials to get inspiration for your project. Once more, going back to that table, you see there is this column. It's about the gender of the contributor, typically a lot of males. And you could convert that into a data visualization for the gender distribution. And you see, instantly see, there are very few women that contributed to the album, only 3 to be exact. And all the rest were male. Here you see occupations. So if you turn this into a data visualization, you get this. This is like an occupation cloud. So these are all occupations that those contributors to the Heijblok album had. And the bigger the sphere, the more people had that occupation. So you get a good idea about the kind of people that Jacob Heijblok was surrounded by. Like many poets and writers and theologians and art painters and professors and academic teachers and playwrights, etc., drawers. You see, he was quite in the upper levels of society back in the 17th century. And finally, from these two columns, date of birth and date of death, you can calculate the lifespans of the people or of the contributors. So this might also, again, help you to get IDs for your project. You might want to something do with old contributors or contributors that lived long. Something like that. It's up to you. This was about the contributors for the Heijblok album, but there are also some contributors available for other alba in the KB collection. And this is what is listed on this page. And you can see, for instance, for the Samuel van den Berg album, there are these contributors available. For the Petronella Moons album, there is also a list of contributors available. And even for the Hiskia Hariksma to Sloten album, there is also a list of contributors available. And as you can see, none of them have images yet, but they might be found one day. Okay, that was pretty much what I had to tell you from here, from Well, I'm not in Germany, but I recorded this yesterday, of course. This is what I had to tell you. If you have any questions, or if you would like to spar, to discuss, to brainstorm about the possibilities, what is feasible and possible with all the materials, the data, the image, etc. I showed you. Or if you need support in your project, and then mainly support related to data and images and Wikimedia, etc., the technical aspects of that, absolutely feel free to contact me. I think it's handiest if you then just send me an email, or if you do that via the course, the assignment coordinator, that's also okay with me. But feel free to contact me, and I can, well, we can have a video chat or something, or perhaps even a physical meetup, just to see, to discuss what's possible. Okay, that was it for me. I'm just going to stop my presentation. How do I do that? Yeah, here I'm back on the screen again. Yes. Okay, have a nice day. For the rest, have a nice drink. I heard you're going to for some drinks after this. Please enjoy, and I hope to see you next time physically, like live. Until then, bye-bye.